I stand before you not as an expert, but as a concerned citizen. One of the 400,000 people who marched in the streets of New York on Sunday, and the billions of others around the world who want to solve our climate crisis.
I'm reaching out to you because we need your help. We want to end gender inequality. And to do this, we need everyone involved.
My grandparents have a lot of, they're very racist.
We call upon all the communities to be tolerant, to reject prejudice based on caste, creed, sect, color, religion, or gender.
No, that's wrong to be. You want to stick with your own race. And I'm like, no, I'm friends with everyone.
Could we really be the great generation that Mandela asked us to be? Might we answer that clarion call with science, with reason, with facts, and dare I say it, emotions? Since the year 2000, since the turn of the millennium, there are 8 million more AIDS patients getting life-saving antiretroviral drugs. Malaria, there are 8 countries in sub-Saharan Africa that have their death rates cut by 75%. For kids under 5, child mortality, kids under 5, it's down by 2.65 million a year. That's a rate of 7,256 children's lives saved each day. The number of people living in back-breaking, soul-crushing extreme poverty has declined from 43% of the world's population in 1990 to 33% by 2000 and then to 21% by 2010. Give it up for that. Look where the amount of people living on $1.25 a day gets to by 2030.
Everybody does their part in a different way. Their mothers are being responsible here and they are getting vaccinated. The nurses are participating in helping the younger generations, you know, in having a healthier community.
If you believe in equality, you might be one of those inadvertent feminists that I spoke of earlier. And for this, I applaud you.
And what else do they feel that in this village? I know that school is very important. What are the other things that they feel that they need in this village?
A health clinic.
No one can stop us. We will speak up for our rights. And we will bring change through our voice. And let us shield ourselves with unity and togetherness.
We are going to win because we don't understand politics. We are going to win because we don't play their dirty games. We are going to win because we don't have a party political agenda. We are going to win because the tears that come from our eyes actually come from our hearts. We're going to win because we've dreams and we're willing to stand up for those dreams. We're going to win if we work together as one, because the power of the people is so much stronger than the people in power.
So let us wage. So let us wage a global struggle against illiteracy, poverty, and terrorism. And And if we want to achieve our goal, then let us empower ourselves with the weapon of knowledge. Education is the only solution. Education first. One child, one teacher, one book, and one pen can change the world.